I'm Jamie Lewis, and welcome back to TheBassist.net. We're here today at Groove Gear headquarters. I love saying headquarters. with Jay Baltimore. And we've got this really cool new product called The Capsule.
Yeah.
Tell me what this is. It looks like a torpedo. A torpedo with wheels. What is this?
That's pretty much what it is. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
So it's our newest guitar and bass case that we've designed. We pretty much combine the soft gig bag that we make today, you know, the technology that we use there, the comfort that we use there, into a case that is pretty much kind of half a solid hard case.
Yeah, you called it a gig bag. I never heard a gig bag do that before.
Exactly.
So this is something different.
It's definitely
a hybrid. A
hybrid
case, okay.
It's definitely a hybrid. That's been tossed around many times and kind of in the industry, but I mean, this truly is a hybrid in the sense of the soft and hard case, because you see here, it's a hard case here all the way down. It's encapsulating your instrument.
Hence the name.
Maybe.
Maybe.
You know, we wrapped the places where it touches your body with soft material, so it feels like a gig bag.
So there would be straps right here.
There would be straps.
This is nice and padded for
you. The straps are removable. It's taken off right now to kind of show you the thing. But, you know, this is would be the mode when you're using. I'm sure you can see that. But there's wheels that are detachable on
here. Down
here, yeah. So you use the wheels, you take off the strap and pretty much roll it like any luggage.
Let's open it up.
Yeah, for sure. The accessory side of this really spans the whole length of the case.
So when I first saw this, I thought this is where the bass went.
Yeah, this is just the front.
This is where cables, what is that, a cell phone?
It's got a wireless power bank here.
So what?
This is a wireless power bank. You put it in there, you put your phone on top of it. If you have an iPhone 8 or newer.
Hey, what if you got an Android? What if you have an Android, Google Pixel?
I think there are some that do wireless charging.
Dude, that is so cool. I had no
idea. We have it listed on the website. I don't know them by heart, but
I thought this was a phone.
No.
This is a charger?
It's a wireless power bank, yeah. There are ports on the top, too. You can charge your iPad and so on.
Whoa!
10,000 milliamp.
How long of a charge do you get on this?
I think you get at least 3 or 4 charges on the phone.
I've been here for like 2 hours and you're still impressing me with new things. I'm still learning new things. Dude, that's so awesome.
So this is this is what we call a power package for the capsule.
Okay.
So this is actually not the final layout. This is a prototype you're looking at, but it's going to be in a case that both of these things are going to be detachable from the case right before checking it in. Because TSA and the whole FAA and everything, they don't allow batteries.
Right. Yeah. Lithium ion batteries. Right.
Lithium ion batteries of a certain size to be checked in. Mm-hmm. So you got to bring it with you. So what we did with this is, and we have it in a demo and in Indiegogo and everything. You take it out, zip it up, put it in your bag.
So you don't have that problem. And then what is this thing right here?
This is a micro headphone amp. It's actually powered by Phil Jones bass.
This is part of the case?
This is an option for the case. And again, there's going to be a placement for it. So you can practice anywhere, anytime. So you got quarter inch cable going in there, you got an aux cable going to your phone or iPod or whatnot.
And you got 2-band EQ, bass and treble?
Yeah.
What?
This thing sounds amazing, by the way. I mean, I've tested this thing so much before we decided to include it in our package. So Phil Jones makes this. He's like the king of miniature stuff.
Dude, that's so cool.
And he's making this specifically for us. He doesn't make a matte black. This is our model with a Groove Gear model.
So. And then in here we've got compartments for...
Compartments for cables, pedals, any kind of accessories, extra strings and whatnot. Down here, it's big enough for a Class D head.
A Class
D
head.
Which I just learned.
You learned that today. We've got one right over here. Let's see if it fits.
Yeah. So we got the Aguilar amp here.
This is a Tonehammer 500. Yep. This is the exact amplifier that I use at the bassist headquarters. Dude.
There you go.
I'll go in there just like that.
Yeah. So this is not a final sizing and everything, but yeah, we were trying to make as many things fit into this thing as possible.
Sure, sure, sure. So you can literally get your bass, your head,
right?
All your cables.
The whole thing is
everything.
We're calling
it
tour ready, right? We got a TSA lock on here. That's fairly standard in high-end luggage that we've adapted into this case. So you set a 3-digit code.
And the zippers are stuck to it.
The zippers are stuck to it. So you enter your code in there. So instead of using a padlock, basically.
Can I set the code to be 12345?
Not yet.
Not yet.
We won't be able to open it. So it is more like a gig bag that we're using zippers on this thing, not latches.
Right, anything. Like in a traditional hard case, you'd have
the latches on it.
Yeah.
And those things, you know, unfortunately when they get tweaked, then you have the hard time like trying to match things up and this is using that kind of soft gig bag. You know, we got your neck brace that's gonna keep things from moving around. A little bit of extra storage over here.
Ah, there you go, the secret compartment.
Yeah, get some more strings and other picks and stuff in there.
Gotta have it.
So this whole thing right here is called an ISO chamber for the headstock.
One of my basses is a Gibson Grabber, and it's got the Flying V headstock. and it kicks backwards, and it won't fit in a lot of cases, and it makes things a headache. Yeah,
not only that, you risk really, I mean, the safety of the instrument itself. If it ever falls over or something, people are get their heads literally cut off on their instrument.
Don't do that.
So don't do that. That's not a good thing. So what that is, I mean, if you look at it from the side, there's a little bit of room.
A little bit
of extra room in there to give it, you know, some open space. So everything is pretty much surrounded by air. And the other thing I should mention, there's humidity control system on this.
What?
It's not on here yet. This is a prototype, but we're going to be putting a pocket over here that we teamed up with a company called Bovita. They're basically the world leader in two-way humidity control. They have these packets that you're going to get in the mail after getting the capsule. That you put it in here. It lasts about 3-4 months. What that does, it keeps it in a very specific humidity level for the instrument. So you're traveling, that thing just keeps it perfect.
And what do you need to do to just soak it in water or something like that?
No, you literally just open out of the pack and put it in.
How long does this pack last?
So 3 to 4 months. And you know that it's time to change it because it crystallizes over time. So when it starts turning into this like crunchy thing, you throw it out and replace it.
Dang.
If it needs humidity, it adds humidity back. If
it does it automatically.
It automatically.
What?
And it takes away humidity to keep it at a perfect level.
Literally, have that technology now?
We do.
Wow.
We're trying to shoot for Bluetooth tracking on this case as well. So we teamed up with a company called Chipolo. We have a branded thing for Groove Gear that's a tracker for Groove Gear. You add in the capsule, you have an app and everything that you can literally voice control it, say, find my capsule, and it'll start ringing backstage or wherever your capsule is.
Dude, that is so cool.
Yeah.
So what can't the capsule do?
Oh, boy.
Is it bulletproof? Can I jump out of a burning building with it?
No parachute yet. That might be an option.
A parachute. That's honestly all that's missing.
We got the room for a parachute. So.
All right. We'll get the Basis limited edition parachute version.
Yes.
It's going into production soon. So don't worry about
it. There you go. You heard it from the basis.net only. So this thing's on Indiegogo right now. Literally just released it last week. It's still up for, it's up for a good month. So you have a chance to pretty much get in on the first batch and, get your hands on one of these. So this really is changing the game. As we call it,
I believe
we're changing
it,
the game.
Yeah, dude, I can't wait to get my hands on one.
Yeah,
absolutely,
for sure.
Dude, that's awesome. Well, so there's a link in the description, so you can go click on that and go check out the Indiegogo campaign and pick yourselves up a capsule, dude, because that's what I'm gonna do.